One of the great binge watchers of recent times is the TV show Narcos. It's the dramatization of the epic battle to take down Pablo Escobar, the narco terrorist who turned Colombia into a war zone.
Well, the real stars of the show are two drug enforcement agents. They're on the couch shortly, but first, a quick look at the show.
Imagine you were born in a poor family, in a poor country. And by the time you were 28 years old, you have so much money you can't even count it.
Narcos tells the almost unbelievable tale of two Americans who took down Pablo Escobar and his drug cartel. Boyd Holbrook plays agent Steve Murphy, while his partner Javier Pena is played by Pablo Pascal of Game of Thrones fame.
Everybody works for somebody.
The scale of the carnage and the struggle to shut down the cartel is such that many people think the show is fiction rather than fact. But for the two men who lived it, it was all too real.
Javier Pena and Steve Murphy, welcome back to New Zealand. It's lovely to have you here. First of all, did you have a thorough check at the border?
We were looking for the wall.
Luckily, we didn't find a wall, so yeah.
But every time you go through customs, when you come into a country, you're sort of looking around going, how are they doing it? Oh, I see what they've done there. Oh, yeah, that's good they took that person away.
Yeah.
Luckily, it wasn't us this time.
Yeah.
This is a crazy story. I mean, it's one of those ones that actually kind of seems more like fiction than fact, but you guys lived this story, right?
You know what? There's a lot of people that do not think it's real, that do not think it really happened. They think it's made up, and believe me, it's not made up. It is real. Yeah, we lived it. So.
Just how bad was Escobar?
Well, we call Escobar the inventor of narco-terrorism, killed between 15 and 20,000 innocent people. His empire was built on terrorism, and if you crossed him, he'd kill you and he'd kill your family.
So what was it like to bring him down then?
It was, in the law enforcement culture, we call this the case of a lifetime. You know, we knew it was a really big case. You're probably never going to have an opportunity to work a drug trafficker at that level again. So you knew the importance and the significance of what you were trying to do. At the same time, you know, the man put a $300,000 bounty on each of us, which is, this was back in the early 90s. So the equivalent of that today is probably several million dollars. So it keeps you on your toes.
How does that make you feel? I mean, it does more than keep you on your toes. Can you sleep at night knowing there's that sort of bounty on your heads?
Yeah, yeah. There's nobody there to collect it. It's not good anymore, so we want to get that out there for sure.
Some of those libidi look he was making.
How much did you guys have to do with the production of the show? Did you work with the actors?
Well, yeah, we worked with them for about a week. We took them to our DEA training academy, and we were consultants on the show. In other words, we told them the truth about the chronology, what the facts were in the chase.
I mean, this was obviously your life, your career for such a long time, and then the show comes along, and you've managed to kind of parlay that into a career, a further career in terms of touring the world and talking to people, right?
This is the last thing we ever thought we'd be doing in retirement, believe me. The speaking business is, you know, this is something that Javier developed years ago when we were still working for DEA. He started down at Baylor University in Texas, and it kind of developed into a little presentation, and it's kind of grown as we were still on the job, but we would only do it for law enforcement. Then when we retired, you know, we picked up a few more shows here and there. Throughout a year, you might do just a few. But when Narcos came out, that first year, I think we did 78 shows. Yeah. The next year we did 82.
Oh, my goodness.
And so we're averaging about 75 shows a year now. This is our fourth year.
So we're happy that Narcos Netflix came up. If not, we wouldn't be here, right?
Of course. And what's the most common thing that people ask you?
All right. I'm not sure I can say it on air, but...
I'll tell you.
Did I have all those affairs? And I laughed. Like, that's what they want to know, if I had all those affairs.
And what do you say?
That's the one part.
You got to come to our show to find out.
I'll just say that's the one part of the show that's true.
Come to our show and you'll find out. Yeah.
Lovely to have you both.
Thank you again
for
the invitation.
So all right. And you can catch more of Steve and Javier at their show, A Conversation on DEA Narcos, tomorrow night at the Opera House in Wellington.